Engineer Ken Maschke loves living and working in the city of Chicago. And from Ken's viewpoint, it's the structures that help bring the city to life. Every day, he gets to move to the pulse of a city filled with vitality, or ride, or climb, even skate.
Just in time.
Ken is a licensed civil engineer at Thornton Tomasatti, a world-renowned engineering firm.
Civil engineering is really the jack of all trades of the engineering profession. It includes transportation, structures, what I do, there's geotechnical, construction, water resources. Together, it's mostly about the infrastructure that we all use and we live in.
Civil engineering goes back to the earliest days of civilization. If anyone's responsible for building this country, it's civil engineers.
Civil engineering is really a people-serving profession, especially when nature throws us a curveball. When it comes to hurricanes, tornadoes, earthquakes, civil engineers are there to make sure that the buildings, the bridges, and the infrastructure stays operating and stays safe for people.
Ken and his team specialize in structural engineering.
Very simply put, structural engineering is making things stand up. Already in my career, I've worked on a huge variety of projects. I've worked on baseball stadiums, football stadiums, practice fields. I've worked on high rises here in Chicago, and even internationally in Denmark and in the UAE, in Dubai. The architect usually gives us a pretty picture of the skin of the building. A structural engineer really looks beyond that into the guts and the bones that hold up that skin.
The team is on their way to one of Chicago's most beloved icons. Rising from the ashes 17 years after the Great Chicago Fire, the Rookery Building was completed in 1888.
Many times we get involved with historic construction and trying to preserve it. At the Rookery Building, we're going in, evaluating the existing structure, and trying to come up with new ways so that crews can keep it in top shape.
The walls are all masonry bearing walls, and the interior is all steel frame construction.
In the drawings, the civil engineers see a story of imagination and innovation.
Pretty cool.
Elevators, electric lighting, plate glass windows, fireproofing, features that define the modern skyscraper. Ken has a desk, but you'll rarely find him there.
Let's open up the drawings and see if we can find out what's going on. Looks like there's a step here. So I'm betting you see how they have the two beams adjacent to each other, that one of these is gonna be high for this part. This bay could have a little more snow load on it.
Then it's off to a presentation. Remarkably, Ken's day has just begun. Ken grew up on a farm, so you'd think the big city would mean a big adjustment. But in just a few short years, he's developed a special connection to the city.
One of the reasons I went into structural engineering was because I wanted to be able to show people what I worked on. I've worked on that building over there. Here's another building I've worked on. Another one on this side of the river. We worked on the Chicago Board of Trade building too. When I was in high school, I didn't know necessarily that I wanted to be a civil engineer. I was good in math and science, but I think the best engineers are those that are very well-rounded and bring together a lot of different ideas.
Some of Ken's projects involve routine structural maintenance. Others push structural design to the limits.
Imagine putting a 50-story building on top of Union Station. That's what structural engineers do. This meant that we needed to look at all the existing foundations and the columns and imagine a way to support the weight of a new structure on top of what was already there.
What most folks don't see are the design challenges that Ken has to face.
If a wind gust were to go and hit the building, this is the behavior that it would most likely start to move at. If it moves too quickly or too much, people might get sick, and then there's no way you could sell space on the top floor.
A city would not be a city without buildings like these, or without rail lines, bridges and roads, water and sewage systems. Things people count on to keep their city working.
There's a lot of work that's involved with maintaining all of these parts of the infrastructure. And I guess engineers need to be a little more Clark Kent than Superman.
That's why civil engineers don't just work with companies like Kent's. You'll also find them in municipal, state, and federal government settings, research facilities, and universities. Ken holds Bachelor of Science and Master of Science degrees in civil engineering.
Very rarely do I work on anything by myself, but together that helps us to come up with the best solution to the problems.
In a sense, their job is to pave the way for the future by incorporating new materials, building techniques, and new ways to save energy.
This is a project that I worked on with some architects trying to envision a way to use a currently undeveloped site in Chicago. We think the idea that we're presenting with green technology offers a way of the future, how buildings in the future will need to be planned and designed in order to be more sustainable in our infrastructure and in our cities.
Green ideas like these are changing the way buildings are being built and renovated all over the world.
I think there are so many other difficult questions in today's day and age dealing with the environmental impact of the building, how to deal with the building's energy needs. Engineers can be more involved with all aspects of that. Instead of just taking the skin that they give us for granted, let's go back and try and engineer a better way.
Ken sees Chicago as a living city, ever evolving and ever in need of improvements.
There's always something new to work on. It's wonderful having that feeling that all your hard work is paid off into something tangible.
As he looks out into the future, Ken can see there's no end to what he can learn and what he can do to help cities like Chicago thrive.